Hey, what's up, Trainiacs? I want to talk about zone training today, specifically with regards to the Team Trainiac platform. So we have devised all of the workouts based off of zones, so that whether you have heart rate, power, or none of that, and you have to use perceived exertion, you're able to do that. We've also given guidance on how to go about setting up your zones, and we've built it right into the platform. So when you log into the platform, to get your zones, you go up here and you click on My Athlete Dashboard. And what you need to do is, as you scroll down, after setting up all your races, you'll see here that it's not set up yet. Now to do that, you click Edit Your Profile. Now to get that set up, you click up here at the top of Modify Your Training Profile. And what you've got to do is scroll down a little bit and you see Get Your Training Zones. The first entry that you've got to put in, you don't have to if you don't have a power meter, but if you do, I will link to a video that I did right up here for a guided FTP test. If you know that, just enter it. So I know that mine is 285. If you've done a max heart rate ramp test, you enter that here, but if you haven't, I will link to a video right up there for how to go about that. So in my case, I know that it's 176. Now it's important that you do that heart rate test based off of this ramp test, not just taking your max heart rate from, say, Garmin or Strava. All of the zones that we've created are specifically in relation to that max heart rate ramp test. It's got to be that protocol or the zones aren't going to be quite right. Then you answer these three questions here. Click Save Your Training Profile Info. And then when you go back to your athlete dashboard, all of those zones will be worked out for you. Now these are the zones that you're going to follow. You're going to spend a lot of time in zone 2, fair bit of time, about 20% of your time in zones 4 and 5. And as the races that you plan on doing come closer, we'll spend more time in zone 3 because that's kind of our race zone. One thing to note, however, is that these zones don't always correlate with each other. So for example, if I give you a brick run to do off of a bike, your heart rate will have climbed quite a bit throughout that bike. And to stay in your zone 2 heart rate is going to be tough. So at that point, you can use zone 2 of perceived exertion. These zones don't always exactly correlate with each other. This is to give you a guideline of which ones you use when, and that's all just part of knowing yourself as an athlete. You'll definitely get there the more you train and the more you use the guided workouts with the commentary and the advice that we use and give in those workouts. So go out there, kill it, Trainiacs.